see down there below you?
The first thing that came to mind, but I don't see it, but it's a village. It's a village.
Mm-hmm. I see a village. Mm-hmm. Look down at the ground. Can you see your feet?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. Take a look and see what your feet look like.
I don't see an image. It's more like...
You feel it?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. So what does it feel like?
It feels like my feet are kind of dirty.
Mm-hmm.
And ugly, like a man's feet.
Mm-hmm. A man's feet?
Uh-huh.
What do you feel like you're wearing?
I don't know, like brown something robe.
Mm-hmm. A brown robe?
Yeah, a brown something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And you say you kind of feel dirty?
Yeah, it feels dirty.
Mm-hmm. What do you feel like you look like?
Fat and ugly.
Fat and ugly?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel?
60.
Mm-hmm. Now, as you're standing there, you say you see a village?
Yeah, it was a village.
Mm-hmm.
See
what you can sense out of this village. Is this a place where you feel like you live there, that you belong there? Or that you're traveling through? What does it feel?
I feel like I'm traveling through that. I don't live there.
So tell me more. What other impressions are you getting?
I don't know. I cannot really see people. It looks a little bit abandoned.
It looks abandoned.
Uh-huh. I see like a roof made out of hay.
Mm-hmm.
And the building, I mean not the building, but the village is like a little houses.
Mm-hmm.
Brown. And they are round. They're round brown.
Round brown houses.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. See if you can sense any activity around you. See if you have any other people there or animals.
I don't see any animals, but I sense that people are hiding.
And they're hiding?
Hiding somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like, I don't know, like, they might be scared they're hiding somewhere.
Mm-hmm. What do you feel that they're scared of?
I don't know, a talk maybe?
Mm-hmm. Okay. And what is it that you're doing in the village? Do you have any feelings that you should be hiding?
I feel scared.
Mm-hmm. You feel scared?
I feel scared. But... I feel like I'm looking for someone.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe a little concerned about...
You're concerned about someone?
Yeah, mm-hmm. I'm looking for someone, I just don't know for who.
Okay, so just take a deep breath in and let's continue with the scene. You'll be able to see it a lot clearer. Just continue to see what it is that you're looking for.
Maybe I'm looking for a woman.
Mm-hmm. Who is this woman that you're looking for? Is she related to you?
I have a feeling she might be my, like, wife.
Mm-hmm.
I think she was lost.
Mm-hmm. She's lost?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Connect with the feelings and see what it is that you're feeling inside. What emotions are coming through?
Afraid and sad.
Mm-hmm.
And hopeless.
Afraid and sad and hopeless.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Why are you feeling these things?
Because there's nothing I can do to help.
Mm-hmm. Nothing I can do to help.
Yeah.
So what is it that's happening?
I think someone came and attacked the village.
Mm-hmm.
And they kill. I don't see that they kill people, but I have a feeling that they did.
All right. So let's go to the moment when you discover what it is that happened in that village. I want you to move forward or backwards to see what it is that's happening in that village.
There are people who are wearing like army jackets that were mm-hmm. on the horses. Mm-hmm. Their jackets were red, and they came in. And they stopped people. They're like looking through every single house. They were just stopping everybody that they saw. Mm-hmm. And those people who lived there were very, very poor. And they couldn't defend themselves. And they just were scared and they died. Mm-hmm. The people on the horses, they wore red jackets, as I said. And they just left and they didn't care about the people they killed.
Mm-hmm. So now I want you to go to the point in that lifetime when you discovered what happened.
That my wife is dead.
Your wife is dead. Mm-hmm. Where are you?
I think I'm like in the little house looking mm-hmm. at her.
What happened to her?
She was stabbed to death.
She was stabbed to death?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I'm just looking at her and feel as I was guilty because I was in there to help her and save her.
Mm-hmm. You felt guilty?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What is it that you were doing that you weren't in the village?
I think I was hiding because I was scared.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So as you're looking at this, how is it making you feel?
Shame that I wasn't there to help. Mm-hmm. Shame of my fear.
Let's close the scene behind you now. Let's close the scene. I want you to move forward to another time in that same lifetime when something important is happening. Move forward and tell me where you are.
Married, I don't know. I feel like I'm getting married.
You're getting married? Mm-hmm. How old are you?
18.
Mm-hmm. Where are you? Look around.
It's just green grass. Mm-hmm. Everything is outdoors. There's nobody. No, there are people, but there are no buildings. It's very... It's not rich. It's not poor. It's just very simple.
Mm-hmm. And look down at yourself. What is it that you're wearing?
Like shoes, like black shoes, I think.
Black shoes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What does your body feel like?
Skinny.
Mm-hmm.
Healthy.
Are you male or female?
I think I'm male.
Mm-hmm. So you say you're getting married. Who's your bride?
I don't know. A girl who is 16.
Mm-hmm. Do you know her or was it arranged?
I think it was arranged. I don't think I knew her.
Okay. So tell me how you're feeling.
Feeling very happy.
You're feeling very happy.
Really, very, very happy.
Mm-hmm. So look around you and tell me who else is with you.
My mother. She's a heavyset lady.
Mm-hmm. A heavyset lady?
Yeah, she has rosy cheeks.
Mm-hmm.
She's wearing like I don't know, like an Amish hat kind of thing. Her head.
Like an Amish hat?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And what else is she wearing?
A long, like, cream dress.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of, yeah, long.
Who else is there?
people I don't recognize.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, it might be my wife's mother, but I don't know.
So let's fast forward a little bit until you meet your bride. Tell me what happens.
It's just normal life. Nothing really. Kind of poor.
Mm-hmm. So you're living a normal poor life?
Yeah, normal poor life. Mm-hmm. Feel living in like a little teeny house. I feel like we have two boys, but I don't know. They're maybe like 4 and 6
mm-hmm.
years old.
And what is it that you do?
A shoemaker.
You're a shoemaker. Mm-hmm. Are you happy?
I am happy. I'm content.
Mm-hmm.
I know I have little, but I'm happy. And it's very simple. I don't know. There's nothing in that life that was complicated. It was just simple. It's mm-hmm. just I knew what I was supposed to do every day, and I did it, and nothing was difficult.
Okay, so let's advance to another time in that same lifetime when you're older. Let's go ahead now. Close that scene behind you. Let's go drifting and floating to your little boulder. Tell me what's happening.
I don't know. I think I'm alone.
You're alone. Mm-hmm.
Alone. I don't think my kids are with me.
Tell me more.
My wife died.
How old are you there?
Let's say like 50.
Mm-hmm. And what do you do in your life now? Did you by yourself?
I don't know. I feel like I'm just reflecting, just sitting in front of my little house.
Mm-hmm.
And then I look at the sheep and different like animals.
Mm-hmm.
Cows, they're cows.
Yeah, you have cows?
Mm-hmm.
So tell me your thoughts. What is it that's going through your mind? How are you reflecting about your life?
I don't know. It feels kind of lost because I had all these hopes and dreams and life was simple, but then I'm just sitting alone. And no one is with me.
Mm-hmm. What kind of feelings are you getting?
Lonely.
Lonely. Are you still working with shoes? Or are you?
No, I kind of left that. I just don't know. Sometimes, not as often. I just like live over land. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's leave that scene behind, close it. And now we're going to go drifting and floating to where you're much older now. What's happening?
I died, I guess.
Mm-hmm. All right. So let's back up a little bit and tell me where it is that you are before you died.
Where? So, like a place or city or. What do you mean?
Mm-hmm. Go to the moment before you died and tell me where you are.
Just outside, like on the. Like the grass part.
Mm-hmm.
Just fall down. I fell down and I'm just laying there staring at the sky.
And what are the thoughts that are going through your mind as you're passing?
That life is pointless. That this life was pointless.
This life was pointless.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's continue the journey as your soul leaves that body and tell me where you go now. What happens to you now?
I see a coma, and I see it's very hot.
You see a camel?
Yeah. It's very hot. I'm wearing a white dress, but I'm a man.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wearing a white turban on my head.
A turban? Mm-hmm. So you're all dressed in white?
I am all dressed in white.
Mm-hmm.
We're going somewhere. It's like there are people are following me in the back. There are people in the back of me and there are people in front of me. They're all riding camels.
Are you walking or riding the camel?
Riding it.
Mm-hmm.
There's someone holding the camel, like trying to direct it, but I'm sitting on the camel.
Mm-hmm.
People are in the back of me. I think that we are going somewhere, moving from one place to the other.
Mm-hmm. So all of you are moving together?
Yeah, we are.
Mm-hmm. And tell me what the feeling is of all these people. What do you get from them? What emotions are you feeling as you're moving?
Like we need to hurry up.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out to see why you need to hurry up so much. What's happening?
I don't know. I think we are running from somebody.
You're running from somebody.
Like we had to move to a different place.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I think the woman I'm with, I don't know if she's my wife or if she's, but I think I took her from somebody else and then he wants to like chase me and kill me because I took what wasn't mine.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about this woman?
I adore her.
Mm-hmm.
She's very vibrant, full of life. She has blue eyes, she has olive skin, brown hair. She's smiling at me and she adores me.
I want you to look straight into her eyes, the eyes of the windows to the soul, and see if those eyes are inside that soul is the same of any soul that is in Anya's life now. Continue on this journey and see where it takes us.
Yeah.
I want you to move to another scene in that same lifetime to see where it is that you end up.
I don't know. I see white houses.
Mm-hmm. Describe them for me.
I'm confused because it looks like kind of like Greek houses, you know?
Mm-hmm.
White, they're not fancy, but they're not poor.
Mm-hmm. What's the terrain look around you?
I don't know, sand, ocean maybe around.
Mm-hmm.
Nice day. It's a beautiful around, everywhere I look.
Mm-hmm. And what are you doing there?
I don't know.
Who are you with?
I'm with my wife. I'm with this woman. I described earlier.
Connect with her and see if you can determine what her name is. What do you call her?
Marie?
What does she call you?
Area?
So let's see what it is that you do in this place. How do you earn a living?
I feel like I'm wise. I feel like I am. Like people follow me. They respect me, and I feel like I'm teaching them something.
Do you feel like you're the leader of this group?
Yeah, I feel like people trust me, and they're not afraid of me. They know I'll protect them, and they know that I'll be there for them. And I have something that they don't, which is like the, I don't know, like the wisdom.
You have wisdom?
Yeah. Respect me for that.
What is it that you teach them?
No, I teach them. What do I teach them? Like, I feel like there was no name for it. But it's. Magic, but it's something to do with like chemistry or something, rocks maybe, like not a shaman, or I don't know.
So let's go to the time when you're doing something that it is that you do. I want you to move into time and space and see yourself doing what it is that you're very wise at.
I don't know, I can see myself like talking to a group of people.
You're talking to the group of people?
Yeah, I'm talking to the group of people. We are sitting outside.
What are you telling them?
I know I have like a white notebook or something. I'm telling them not to be afraid.
You're telling them not to be afraid?
Yeah, I don't know of what.
Who is this that you're telling?
They're mostly men. There. Mostly men. They're no woman. I just don't know what I tell them. I cannot remember what I tell them.
Does what you tell them come out naturally from you?
Right now.
Where does this wisdom come from? What is it?
I feel like I had a gift back then in that life. That was not something that people could. It's not something you can describe. But it was just a gift.
Alright. So I want you to go deep into that life. And we're going to move forward to where you're older now. Drift and float through time and space. You're older now. Where are you?
there are people around me everywhere. I think they're waiting for me to die or something.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm still very, very, I don't know, optimistic or pure.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very not afraid. I have a lot of like love in my heart, and people can feel it.
People can feel it.
Mm-hmm.
What emotions are you feeling?
I feel sad because.
What do you feel?
I feel sad because I feel like I'm dying.
Mm-hmm.
Those people were counting on me to guide them and to teach them, but I'm leaving and they will be alone.
Mm-hmm.
And they wouldn't progress, they wouldn't learn, they would just feel like I've made their life better.
Mm-hmm.
And after what I'm done, they wouldn't have it, and I feel sad.
Mm-hmm. So do you feel like you're abandoning them?
Yeah, but it's not my choice. I have to go.
Mm-hmm.
But still, I can't help it to feel sad for them. I feel like if I could just stay a little bit longer. But I know I can't.
Mm-hmm. What's wrong with your body?
Just old.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
I don't know, like 90.
Mm-hmm. You live a long age?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are you alone or is your wife still with you?
I don't think my life wife is with me anymore.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so I want you now to go to the last breath that you take. And tell me what happens as you transition to the other side. I want you to follow your soul.
I float.
Mm-hmm.
Of the house I was in. I see the village and then I float. It's so peaceful.
Mm-hmm.
I float and then I see a light, I guess.
You see a light?
I mm-hmm. see a light. It's very beautiful. I am not afraid.
Mm-hmm.
I feel light. I just go through this motion.
When you go through the light?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So what happens inside of the light?
I don't know. I see there are people there waiting for me.
Mm-hmm. What do they look like?
There's a man who's wearing sandals and like a skirt, brown, like a brown dress, like a gladiator dress, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
I see a woman wearing a white dress. I don't know, there are like about 20 people there.
Mm-hmm.
I just cannot see their faces.
Mm-hmm. You could see how they dress, but you can't see their faces?
Yeah.
Take a look at them and see why you can't see their faces. What are they made out of?
They look like human, but
mm-hmm.
maybe I see everything else except the face.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And what is it that they're doing there? Are they welcoming you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you know them?
I don't know.
See if you recognize any of them. If they feel familiar.
I just feel like I cannot imagine. I don't see the body.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like the energy of my brother,
mm-hmm.
not my little brother.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't see his body.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I sense energy of Mike and my sister, but I don't see her body. I don't know. I just don't see her body.
So let's see what happens next, now that you meet all these people. Where do you go?
I see a man who is like made out of light,
mm-hmm.
pure light, and he takes me and he wants to talk to me.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what he says. I want you to, as he talks to you, tell me what he says to you.
He tells me that my life was ended because it was time for me to go in that other life that I just came from, that I did good for other people and I was free to go, that my mission was done.
Mm-hmm. What was your mission in that life?
To make people better, to make their life, to be there for them when they were lost.
Mm-hmm. And do you feel that you did a good job?
Yes, I felt like I did a very good job. I felt like I've healed them, and I felt like I've helped them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was very happy, and I was very content with myself.
Mm-hmm.
And with this life and the people who were around me. And I feel like the energy is telling me that I can choose another life.
Mm-hmm. So what would you like to learn in another life?
I think that I wanted to learn how to be lost.
Mm-hmm.
I want to learn how to suffer and how to live suffering.
And what is the purpose of learning this?
I think it will help me better as a healer,
because
I know what people will go. I know what people will go through, or what they go through. I just need to learn how to go through life and suffering.
So, who will you take with you in this life? What is the contract that you have with him?
As to, you make me suffer, and I just have to learn to live with this suffering and not take it too deep.
Mm-hmm.
I have to understand that this is just a lesson.
Mm-hmm. Does he agree to this?
Yes. He does, because he loves me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Who else are you taking with you?
I don't know. Pam? Taking Pam with me. I have no idea who Pam is.
Mm-hmm.
But she's a woman. I don't know what she looks like.
Mm-hmm. What is her purpose for being in your life?
She's going to make me suffer.
Mm-hmm.
Really, really suffer.
Mm-hmm.
And she agrees to it.
Mm-hmm.
And then she asks something for exchange, but I don't know what it is.
Mm-hmm.
I think I have to love her.
Mm-hmm.
I love her and she will make me suffer.
Mm-hmm. What role will she play in your life, in your next life?
I think she... She's going to be Tony. That sounds crazy, but I'm going with it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so Pam, the woman who I've met out there, is going to come back as a man, I think. My mom is there too, volunteering.
So what is her purpose in being in that life? The next life. What is the contract that you have with her?
Make sure I suffer too, but not greatly.
Get more information from her. Done this before in other lifetimes with her?
No, I don't think so.
What is she volunteering for now?
She wants to be my mother, I guess, again, or I don't know, it's kind of confusing.
Ask your guide to help you figure things out. Look for your guide. Ask your guide to show himself or herself.
He's in front of me.
He's in front of you? So what does he have to say to you?
To be brave.
To be brave?
Not to be afraid. He's telling me that I chose everything in my life because I wanted to learn.
You wanted to learn?
I wanted to learn everything. I was eager to learn, and I chose it. And I chose more than what he recommend.
You chose more than what he recommends?
Yeah.
And why is that?
Because I'm overachiever, I don't know.
You're an overachiever?
And I thought I could handle it. He tells me not to be afraid. And I agree with him. He tells me that I'm an old soul.
You're an old soul?
Me that he's been with me for a very, very long time.
A very long time?
Yes.
So he's been your guide for a long time? Does he have a name?
Yeah.
And what are the gifts that you're going to be bringing into the new life with you?
Wisdom.
Wisdom?
Wisdom, courage.
Mm-hmm. What else?
I feel like I want to say sex appeal, but I don't know if that's a gift or not.
Mm-hmm. Are you going to choose to be a man or a woman in the next life?
I think a woman.
Mm-hmm. What is the decision to be a woman about?
Because I've been a male for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like as a woman I can be hurt more, much more,
mm-hmm,
than as a man.
And it's important to be hurt and suffer?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's very, very important for me to learn this.
Mm-hmm.
And also that suffering doesn't kill me.
The suffering doesn't kill you?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Just make everyone stronger as long as I turn to love.
As long as they turn to love. So the people that are going to be in your life will be making you suffer?
And yes.
Mm-hmm. And what is it that you have to remember?
Remember that I chose this, and I have to remember that this is all an illusion.
All an illusion.
Pain is an illusion that we kind of human gave ourselves. Pain doesn't really.
Mm-hmm.
Pain is not really what we think it is.
Pain is not what we really think it is. What is it?
Directed in a specific place.
Mm-hmm.
But if we let pain pass through us, it will just dissolve.
So you just have to allow the pain to go through and dissolve?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's an energy?
Pain is an energy.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like just with everything else.
So when the pain gets stronger, it's because it's blocked?
Yeah, because we focus too much on it.
Mm-hmm.
To be kind of transparent.
Transparent, the pain will go through?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And that we cannot hold to the pain.
Don't hold the pain.
No, let it go.
Mm-hmm.
Set it free. And there you will be free. It's just an illusion. It's just an illusion.
So you will be suffering quite a bit and you have to remember that it's just an illusion.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what happens now?
I feel like I thank my guide. I feel like I'm looking at the people who are coming with me.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like we smile at each other, and we say that we love each other dearly. Every single one of them, all the people that I'm choosing to hurt me, they love me so very, very much. And I love them so very much too.
So all the people that are going to be in your new life are already gathered there? And there's a big love fest going on?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What do you tell each other?
We tell each other that we love each other.
We love each other.
We tell each other to see you soon.
See you soon?
Yes. And then I go.
Then you go? Tell me how you go into your next life.
I see light.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like I'm coming down.
You're coming down in the light?
Yeah, I'm coming from the light. And I'm just kind of cruising around. I see planets, I see yellow planets, I see white planets, there are different planets around me, and I look at it like it's not a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
I just float around and I'm going down and down,
mm-hmm.
and down, and I see. What do I see after? Okay, I see light again.
And which direction are you going? Are you going straight down or backwards or which one?
I'm going straight down.
Mm-hmm.
It's a while to get down. It takes a while. And now I don't see dark anymore. I see light. I just don't know what else I see. Other than it's just light and I don't see the planets anymore.
Mm-hmm. Do you see light?
I see light.
What color is it?
It's just like a daylight.
Mm-hmm.
Light. I don't know what else to say.
Do you feel you have a body now? Tell me when you feel you have a body.
I have a body.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about it. What does the body look like?
I'm a woman.
You're a woman.
And I am just like 1800s, maybe. I'm snobby.
You're snobby?
Yeah. I have a long dress. I have an umbrella to protect me from the sun.
Mm-hmm.
I'm walking outside, strolling down with somebody, with a man who is trying to get my attention. I think he wants to marry me or what he like. Assisting me, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know because everything seems fine. I feel like I'm fragile and gentle.
Mm-hmm.
I live well. I think, I don't know, I don't see the house. I see myself and I know I look different because there are people who are around me. I don't know them. They're just passing by, but they're dressed differently than I am.
Mm-hmm. How are they dressed?
They're dressed like in the brown, like cloth.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm not.
Who are these people?
They live in the place, like village, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Where do you live?
I live in a big house. It's mm-hmm. white. It's white, a two-story. It's a flat roof. I feel like it's the south, like mm-hmm. somewhere in America, weirdly.
Mm-hmm. And what do you do there?
I don't work.
You don't work?
I don't work. I feel like I've been taken care of by a family who are wealthy.
Mm-hmm. You live with a wealthy, you come from a wealthy family?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And when you see these people wearing brown, how do they make you feel?
Bad.
Bad? Mm-hmm. Why?
Because I know they look up to me and they want to be like me and I want to help them and I want them to be as equal as me. I don't want them to feel like they are beneath me. I want them to be wealthy too, but I can't.
Mm-hmm.
It makes me sad, even though I have all the wealth, Mm-hmm. But it makes me kind of sad for the people who are. There's nothing I can do for them. I think it's not because I cannot do it because someone forbids me from helping them, and I feel like it's my father. I feel like he cannot stand that I talk to these people because he tells me that these people are not the same as I am and I shouldn't be talking to them.
Mm-hmm. So let's close the scene and go to the place where you live, and we're going to see you at a meal time with your family. I want you to go to the time where you're with a meal, having a meal with your family, and tell me what's happening.
You know, I feel like it's a long table, like maybe 12 people around.
Mm-hmm. 12 people?
12 people at the table.
Mm-hmm. Who are these people?
I think they're my family. I see my father, my mom too. My father is kind of very controlling.
Mm-hmm.
He's very mean. He doesn't let me be. He's mean to me and he's mean to my mom. Mm-hmm. And he's mean to my siblings. And my brother is turning to be like him. I think he's my brother. He's sitting at a table.
Mm-hmm.
I think I am like maybe 16 years old.
Mm-hmm. I want you to take a look at your father's eyes. Look deep into your father's eyes. The eyes are the window into your soul. See if you recognize those eyes from anybody in the life of Anya.
I feel like he's my father right now in this lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
Mean. He also has blue eyes like the father in the other lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
He was hitting me. It doesn't make any sense.
Mm-hmm. So what happens next?
Sitting and eating.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is beautiful around. There are mirrors.
How are you dressed?
I am dressed proper. I have a hat with a feather in it. I am wearing a long dress. I look very proper.
Mm-hmm.
And my skin is super pale.
Why are you so fragile?
I'm scared of my father, and I'm scared because I have no right. I feel like I have everything but the right to speak, right to think, right to be myself. I have to just be there and take it all that is given to me, and I cannot object to anything. I don't want this life.
So let's move on. Let's close that scene behind you. Move on to another scene that's very important. Something is happening in that scene. Move ahead to that life point.
My father wants me to marry somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Who I hate.
Who is this man that he's making you marry? Your father is me?
The man.
The man?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Is he older than you?
I feel like he is. He's bold.
Mm-hmm.
He's not ugly. And my father wants me to marry him because he's extremely wealthy.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want to. I don't care about wealth. I just care about speaking my mind, and I just care about being her. hurt. And I don't want to marry him.
Take a look at his eyes. Look deep into his eyes. And see if you recognize those eyes in anyone in the life of Anya.
I feel like that's my brother.
Mm-hmm. Feel the energy.
Cold.
Cold.
Mm-hmm. The energy is just cold and unstoppable and unreasonable.
Mm-hmm. How old is he?
40. He's 40 and I'm not.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't make sense.
You're 18?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what happens next between you and this man.
I hate him. Don't want to be there. I don't want to be around him. If nothing drastic happens, I just...
How do you feel?
I feel... like I'm dying.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like I have tape on my mouth because I cannot speak.
You have tape on your mouth?
Right. Because I cannot speak. Maybe I feel like I'm sitting on a chair and my hands are tied to the back of the chair and I have tape on my mouth.
Mm-hmm. And who's taped you to that chair?
My husband.
Your husband has taped your hands to the back of the...
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think he wants to show me that he has the upper, he has the last word, he has, like, he's the master of my faith.
Mm-hmm.
And he's tired of me being stubborn.
Mm-hmm.
And he wants to teach me a lesson. And he wants me to pay attention to him. And I cry and I look at his eyes and he doesn't care. He's cold.
How old are you there?
25, maybe?
Mm-hmm. So what happens next?
He hits my cheek. And I'm staring at him without saying anything. And he hits me like my cheek again, not with a fist, but maybe like a slap.
With a what?
Like a slap, but like not a fist.
A slap to you? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. He slaps your cheek?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then he laughs.
He laughs at you?
He does.
How are you feeling?
I feel worthless.
Worthless.
Yeah. I feel like I have no power to stop it. And I feel like there's nothing I can do to change it, to change my situation. I just have to go through it. I just have to be in the situation.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even cry. I just stare at him and it drives him crazy that I don't cry.
You're a very strong woman.
It seems as even though I go I look like I'm very fragile on the outside, but inside, I'm almost like a stone.
You're like a stone? Have you built up this stone to keep yourself protected?
Yes. It's just the only way to survive. That's horrible cage-like marriage and life where I don't have a voice to speak and to express my thoughts.
So let's move ahead and see what happens now.
I feel like I killed myself. That doesn't make sense, but I feel like I killed myself.
Let's go back in time to see right before you killed yourself, see what was happening. Go to that scene.
I feel like I just felt hopeless.
You felt hopeless?
Yeah, and I felt it would never end, and my life was too long, and I could not do anything about it. And I did not want to live this way, because I have nothing to live for.
So how are you planning to kill yourself?
Hang myself.
You hang yourself? So I want you to go to the point where, right before you die, and tell me what is going through your mind. What are the last thoughts that are going through?
I should have not done it. I should have stuck and hang in there, not meaning in my life longer. I should have just gone through it.
Just go through it? So do you feel regrets now?
Yes, I do feel regret because I didn't do what I came to do, which was endure this suffering, and I didn't, and I ended it. And I felt like I shouldn't have.
So I want the spirit to follow the white light again, and I want you to see yourself in front of your guide discussing this last life. What's happening? Who's there with you?
My guide. And people, but mainly, I only see the guide. He looks at me with a gentle. He has a body and gentle eyes. And he puts his, I don't know, like arm around me. And he says, just a little life that I've had many, many lives, and I will have many, 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 many more to make this up.
What was the purpose of that lifetime?
Endure suffering and live with suffering. And I didn't do it.
Didn't do it. So what else is your guide telling you?
He tells me to choose another life. I wanted to. tells me that I don't have to repeat this life.
Mm-hmm.
I can be anything. He tells me that he loves me.
Mm-hmm. I want you to move to the time when your guide is speaking to you about the upcoming life as Anya. And ask him what it is that you are supposed to be learning in that lifetime as Anya.
I'm supposed to learn that suffering is a choice.
Suffering is a choice?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Suffering is a choice. I'm supposed to learn to forgive people who have hurt me and not hold it against them, therefore holding it and hurting myself. Because I am hurting other people.
Learn forgiveness. So that is the purpose of the life of Anya?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why did she choose that life?
To forgive.
To forgive. Mm-hmm. Would you allow your guide to connect with your higher self?
Yes.
Do I have permission to ask questions?
Yes.
Thank you. Tell me the truth. Is this the higher self?
Yes, I feel that it is.
Thank you. Anya wanted to know what her purpose in life was. And her guide had given her one thing, which was forgiveness. From the higher self's perspective, what is she supposed to be doing in this lifetime?
Supposed to be here. Supposed to be alive.
Can you speak a little louder so that she can hear you on the recording?
She's supposed to break. Life.
Supposed to bring life?
Life and to other people.
To other people. Mm-hmm.
How
can she do this?
She can see people's suffering. She can sense it. Sense people, the thoughts.
Mm-hmm. Is she empathic?
I think, yes, she is.
Mm-hmm. So how can she use these gifts of being an empath and feeling other people's pain to help them?
She can heal them.
Mm.
She can talk to them. She can guide them. She can direct them.
Is she on the right path now?
She will be.
Mm-hmm.
She will be is coming. In a few years.
In a few years. Okay, because she's very concerned about not finding her passion, not finding things that she's good at. Is this something that's coming in the future?
Yes, She needs to learn how to be ordinary first.
To be ordinary?
Yes.
Tell her about that. What does that mean?
She needs to learn how to fit in with other people and live and be around them before she can see her true gifts. She needs to be patient, and she needs to live with what's given to her now. So she can appreciate. She has to grow more. She has to grow more. She cannot let her insecurities to stay on the way. That's a noise to distract her purposely. If she learns to overcome this, then her true purpose will be revealed.
But you're not going to reveal that purpose at this time?
I can only see a healing ability for her. She has power in her hands. Her energy is powerful. She can learn. She is a healer, and she can heal people with her hands. She can see people's future as well. And she can overcome. She can help people, but preventing them, because she can see the future.
She can see their future?
She has healing hands. She has to learn to direct her energy in her hands. And she can heal people with her hands.
So should she be taking some sort of a course? Maybe Reiki or reconnective healing?
Yes, healing. She should. She should focus on this, and it will come to her. It will come to her when the time is right. 40 years of age, she will see. You will come just as the sun comes to life, with no effort, with nothing really. She will just awaken, and she will see it. She will see the gift that was given to her, which is a healing ability to heal people around her, and seeing hurt in people, and healing.
Is there anything that she needs to do spiritually to get on this path of healing?
She needs to meditate more frequently. She needs to be persistent with her meditation. She needs to be consistent. She also needs to write. Her power lies in writing. It's very, very powerful to her. She needs to write.
Is this the poetry? Or anything?
Anything she writes is powerful, and it gives her answers she's longing to hear and to see. Everything will be revealed in writing. This is the way she can see and have and the answers to any questions she wishes to know. She is extremely powerful healer. She can see the future. She's very pure. She is childlike, but she is afraid to show people her true self.
Now, you showed her a life of a very wise man. Is this the power that he had in that lifetime?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, it is. That's exactly what it is.
So is that why you showed that to him?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But you also showed him that, when we were discussing with that man, he was being told that his next lifetime would be of suffering. Is this something that is carrying on in this lifetime with her?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. The suffering came because she asked for it before.
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't fulfill it because she gave up too early.
Mm-hmm.
And then the suffering came in this lifetime because she asked for it just to suffer.
Mm-hmm. Does she need to continue with the suffering?
No, her suffering is done.
Mm-hmm.
She had suffered enough. She had fulfilled her contract when it comes mm-hmm. to suffering. It's her time now to be the one who heals people. It's her time to be the one who shows people the right path. She's done suffering. Now she needs to be patient and consistent.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything that's being dragged along, though, from that lifetime where she committed suicide, because she feels right now the same worthlessness from that lifetime? Can we heal that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. She doesn't need that anymore. That came from that young woman who killed herself, it seems.
Yes, he did. Mm-hmm. She carried it with her.
She carried it with her.
Yes, because she thought it would help her.
Mm-hmm. What do you have to say to her about that?
To let go, it doesn't help you, you're free.
Mm-hmm.
So it was then, not now.
So she doesn't need to worry about not being able to speak her mind and feeling like she's not smart enough?
Yeah, she doesn't have to. It's not important. She is so wise.
Mm-hmm.
And she knows things that other people don't know. And she's just afraid that what she knows is not important enough.
Mm-hmm.
Because people who are around her don't feel the same way. They're not on the same level as she is. And she feels like she doesn't belong
mm-hmm.
in that circle because she knows and sees other things.
So what would you recommend? A new circle of friends?
I recommend not to worry about this. I recommend to meditate. And I recommend, as always, to go within you and within her to see all the answers, because everything she needs to know is around her. And all the friends that she has around her right now is not important other than to teach her to be patient with herself and other.
When she meditates, will she be able to communicate with you or with her guide?
Yes. She has a great ability to meditate and to be easily connected to all that she needs to know. Everything will be given to her. She just needs to be persistent and consistent.
Well, she knows that she's powerful already because she was able to manifest a wonderful companion in her life, partner.
Yes.
What would you like to tell her about the rest of her life? How she can manifest the life of her dreams?
Write and meditate. Those are your two powerful tools. Everything is going to come to you. Everything that she wants and longs for, everything is hers to take, except she needs to make her mind to do it, and she needs to learn to be consistent and stick with the regimen of meditation.
How often should she meditate?
Every day.
Every day? For how long?
Half an hour.
Okay, good. She also has questions about her career. She feels like she's not doing important enough work. She wants to find her passion, her talents. She wants to know what her talents are. You said that it's healing, but what about something as far as a job is concerned?
She has ability to make people feel wonderful when they are around her. Her energy is beautiful at times when she meditates. She should choose to work with people who are hurting. And she should do work with suffering people.
What can she do for them?
She can listen to them. She can help them. She can guide them. Organizations. Like non-profit organizations she can get involved with. There are plenty of suffering people around. She needs to get out of her circle of the bubble. She needs to go outside of her circle if she truly wants to fulfill her spiritual life.
And she just needs to listen to them?
Yes.
Will she be using those talents from that man that was a wise man?
Yes, she is.
How can she tap into that man's abilities?
I feel like she just needs to meditate and concentrate on her hands. As her hands have ability to heal.
So she'll be doing some hand work, putting hands on people?
Yes, she should.
She listens to them?
Yes, she should heal people with her hands.
Will she be doing that officially, or will she just be touching them and healing them as they talk to her?
Touching. No, she will be healing them as they are talking to her. And they will come, they will find her, or she will find them. It's just not the right time right now.
No,
but it's not far, a few years.
Okay, should she continue in that job that she has now?
No. Not for long.
No.
For another year.
And then what? Where should she go then?
it will happen spontaneously.
Okay.
It will just happen. It will just happen. She doesn't have to worry. But I see her speaking to people.
Mm-hmm.
I see her speaking to a large amount group of people. She's standing on a podium some sort, and everyone looks at her with amusement. Everyone is waiting for her to say, and she speaks. She speaks her wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
And that helps people.
That seems quite contrary to the life that she has now, where she has such doubt about her abilities. She feels that what she says is not important enough.
It is. It really, really is. The trick is for her to overcome that. Overcome that barrier that she has to do before she can go and heal other people.
Mm-hmm. Could you work on her at night when she's sleeping so that we can heal all of those past life impressions that she received?
Yes, I'll be happy to do it.
Mm-hmm. Because we don't need to have that bleeding over into this life.
No.
If we can follow that cord into that life and just disconnect her from it so she doesn't feel that problem of lack of confidence and not being good enough.
Mm. Yes, yes.
Wonderful. She has a question about her husband and why is it that he is in her life now.
He is an angel who came to show her how beautiful she is. He sees her for truly who she truly, truly, truly is. And he is there when she's in doubt to remind her of her beautiful self, of her healing power, and of her powerful ability to make people feel wonderful when they are around her. He reminds her of all of this. He is her guide, her savior. He reminds her all the things that she has forgotten about. He is with her.
Mm-hmm. Is she supposed to learn anything from the relationship also?
She's supposed to learn not to judge him as she judges herself. As she doubt herself, she should let go of all of those baggage she has.
Mm-hmm. All that baggage from the past lives?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, she needs to let go of that.
Mm-hmm. Help her with that so that she can let go of that baggage.
Yes.
Good. We ran across her husband in another past life. Has he been in others with her?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
He was the woman.
Uh-huh.
He was the woman.
And she was helping him in that lifetime as a wise man.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Where was this?
Greece.
In Greece. What year was it?
1570.
Okay. She also had a question about one time when she hypnotized herself and she saw herself as a woman with dark long hair, and she was giving birth to a baby girl, and the husband was near her, but the baby died, and she was very sad because she left her baby. Can you tell her about that life?
She died giving birth because that's the life she had chosen. She chose to die, and the baby she left behind was her mother now.
Okay. So what was the purpose of that, leaving that baby behind?
The baby needed to learn how to be resourceful on their own, how to live with the father without having a mother in their life. I was supposed to serve a purpose of learning for that baby. The baby chose that life. It wasn't her fault. She felt guilty, but it's not, wasn't her choice.
So can we remove that guilt from her?
Yes.
Let's remove all of that, disconnect all of those connections to that life so that she doesn't feel that guilt anymore.
Okay.
And while we're talking about babies, she's feeling very indecisive in her life right now, whether she should have a baby or not. This is something that she should be doing, because she's very afraid of it.
She's afraid of having a baby because she's afraid that she would die and leave this baby alone as she did before.
Does she need to hold on to this any longer?
She doesn't. There's no purpose in holding on to this. That contract has been closed and fulfilled a long time ago.
Okay, so she's 38 years old, she's married. What's stopping her from having a baby now? Is there a baby waiting for her? Or is it not in the cards?
Fear is stopping her. Fear of not being a good mother. Fear of not providing. Fear of not meeting needs of the baby.
Is there a reason she should continue holding on to it?
There is no reason. It's just fear that lingered from past life. How scary. This isn't her, Anya's fear. It's not her.
It's not her fear. It was the fear of that woman who died.
It was her, exactly.
So we can disconnect that from her?
Yes, we can.
Okay, go ahead and disconnect that so she doesn't have that fear. Take that away from her. And do you see a baby in her future?
Yes, there is a baby. Who is select her as a mother.
Has this baby been in her life before?
No.
No. What is the reason this baby is looking at her for to be a mother?
The baby wants her guidance. She needs to be the loving person for that baby. She needs to be be the strength for this baby.
Okay, good. Just a question about Tony and why they were together. What lessons was she supposed to learn from this?
She chose this suffering. She chose this lesson is to forgive.
Mm-hmm.
To forgive without holding the hate.
Mm-hmm. Has she done that?
She partially had forgiving, however, there is still some part of it that needs to be let go of.
Mm-hmm.
She must let go and forgive, as this is not serving her any purpose. The mission, the contract has been done.
Okay, so she just needs to let go and forgive.
Yes, she does.
Is she ready to do that now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right. So I'm going to have Anya take a deep breath in. And see yourself in front of Tony. And I want you to tell Tony, we tried, we really tried, but it's not working.
We tried, really tried.
But it's not working.
But it's not working.
Let's break the contract.
Let's break the contract.
So I want you to see yourself tearing a piece of paper with his contract.
Yes, I am tearing.
And just letting it go. Throw it up and let it go. Let it blow in the air. And just tell him, I forgive you. I let you go. We don't need to be together anymore.
We don't need to be together anymore.
Mm-hmm. How does that feel?
I feel light, but
just because you break a contract doesn't mean you let go of the person. You're just letting go of the contract.
Okay, I don't want to let go of
the person. You don't have to let go of the person. You can break a contract with anybody.
Okay.
But just forgive him.
Okay, I'll forgive you because
And forgiving doesn't mean that what he did was right. It just means that you're going to stop hurting because of what he did.
Yes.
So just look at him and just tell him that you forgive him and you let him go.
I forgive you and I let you go.
And how does it feel now?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Good. So let me speak with your higher self. Take a deep breath in. And just let me speak with your higher self. Anya had a question about her family. She says that she gets along only with Joanna.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody else is a challenge. Why is it such a challenge for her?
She chose this again to learn. Suffering. She wanted to experience suffering. And she took more than was recommended. Mm-hmm. She chose that. She chose her family.
Mm-hmm. Same with the father. who was seeing evil in that other lifetime. She chose him again.
Yes. Yes.
And she chose her mother.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And even her uncle.
Yes, she chose everything.
Mm-hmm. Does she still have spiritual contracts with all of these people? Or do we just realize, does she realize that they all love her on the other side?
The contracts.
Mm-hmm.
She needs to work on fulfilling her contracts.
Mm-hmm. What contract does she have with her father?
She needs to love. She needs to be loving. Mm-hmm. She needs to forgive him for everything that he has done to her.
Mm-hmm.
And she should love him and look at him as a beautiful being that he is.
See him as a soul, not as a person?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What is her contract with her sister, Johanna?
Johanna was sent as her guide.
Mm-hmm.
Johanna is light, always been light. Johanna was sent to help her in this experience. Joanna's been with her for a very long time. Everywhere they go together. They do help each other.
Mm-hmm. So they have been sisters before?
They have been wife and husband.
Okay. What's her contract with her sister?
Accept her and accept something she cannot change.
Mm-hmm. So accept her as she is?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So she cannot change her sister?
She cannot. She can only change the way she views her. Sister has contracts on her own.
Okay. What about her brother?
Acceptance.
Acceptance also. She seems to have that as a main theme in this life, is acceptance and forgiveness.
Yes.
We talked about the fact that she's very judgmental.
Concentrate her energies on something is pointless and it does not serve her. It doesn't serve her. It stops her. It slows her down. She must get rid of judgments for self and others.
Mm-hmm.
As this is blocking her energy.
Is this what's causing her the pain that she feels in her abdomen? In her chakra?
The pain is insecurities, yes.
Mm-hmm. When she speaks about, or she thinks about her husband's ex-wife, even listening to her name, she feels that pain. Can you tell her why this woman is in her life?
She chose every single person in her life, and she chose them because she wanted to learn forgiveness.
Mm-hmm.
She wanted to learn to be forgiving and loving.
Well, she's got a lot of people to learn from.
It's a work in progress.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But it's not going to be as much suffering as she already had endured before.
Mm-hmm. It'll be easier for her now?
It is easier.
Okay. So talking about this woman in her life, did they both choose to be in each other's lives?
Yes, they did. They both did.
Mm-hmm. And what do you see her relationship being like? What is the purpose of it?
I see acceptance of each other, acceptance of the things that you cannot change,
mm-hmm.
acceptance of life and everything that comes with it, everything that comes on your path. It is temporary and it's not here to stay.
Did they know each other from a different life?
They've met before.
Mm-hmm. They have met before?
They have mm-hmm. met before.
And what about the daughter? The daughter seems to instantly like her. Have they known each other before?
The daughter. Yes, they've met each other briefly. The daughter is the baby. She perhaps had before.
Mm-hmm. They've been each other, they've known each other in different lives?
Yes.
Okay. We have questions about her low self-esteem. Where exactly did that come from? Which lifetime?
She was locked in the room, dark room, and she couldn't breathe.
She was locked in a dark room?
Yes, she couldn't breathe.
Mm-hmm.
She was locked in the room for speaking her mind.
Mm-hmm.
In a place where a woman couldn't do it.
Mm-hmm. So what happened when she was in that room? Did she disconnect a part of her from that life?
She suffered and she didn't want to feel suffering.
Mm-hmm.
And she felt powerless.
Mm-hmm. Did she split off part of her soul?
Seems as she did.
Okay, can we reconnect that? I'd like you to follow that thread into that lifetime and see where that piece of her soul is so that we can reconnect it with her. Tell me where that piece went to.
Another body.
Another body?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Can we follow that thread and connect it again?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We need to reconnect all the parts that are missing from that lifetime where she was locked in that room. If you're missing a part of your soul, if you're fragmented, you're never going to feel whole again. So I'd like the higher self to find all of the missing pieces in that lifetime and bring them all together again, and tell me when you've done that.
Yeah.
You found them?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. tell me when you're done.
Okay.
Would you do a body scan on Anya now and tell me what you find?
Energy blockage.
Energy blockage. Where is it being blocked?
Her head and her stomach.
Her head and her stomach. Would you tell me what's blocking that energy there?
Fear.
Okay. Has she created something out of that fear?
No.
Can you clear that fear out for her?
Yes.
Okay. And I'd like to get it. Archangel Raphael involved now to assist with this, if you permit him.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And tell me when that fear has been blocked out of her head, has been taken out. Wonderful. Now you said she had another blockage. Is that in the area of the solar plexus?
Yes.
What's causing that?
Fear.
Fear again. What is that fear coming from? Past life? Mm-hmm. What is connecting her to that past life? What fear?
Anger.
Mm-hmm. Can you follow that fear into that past life and tell me where it is?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where did it come from?
She was forced to kill.
She was forced to kill?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
She was a soldier.
A soldier.
Kind of like, I don't know, in Rome. She was forced to kill.
Mm-hmm. And that's been, and the anger came out from that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Does she need that anymore?
No.
Let's disconnect that.
Okay.
Disconnect that and dissolve it.
Okay.
I'd like the higher self to just dissolve all of that anger and all of that fear in her body. Use your white light to dissolve all of it. And did it disconnect her from that life?
Mm.
Follow it all the way up to that life and just dissolve.
Mm.
Let me know when you're done. What is she feeling in her solar plexus now?
Light energy.
Light and energy?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What color light are you putting in there?
White.
Beautiful. Reference source?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Let me know when you're done with that.
And,
you're done?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What else do you find in her body during your scan?
Nothing else.
Nothing else? Mm-hmm. She had told me that her brain kind of felt foggy sometimes, her mind. It was hard to remember things. Why is this occurring?
She must forget painful situations from her past life.
Okay, she wanted to forget these situations?
Yeah.
From her past life or this life?
Both.
Both, okay. So is this a bad thing?
She should not learn to forget. She should not learn. She shouldn't suppress it.
She shouldn't suppress it?
Right. She should let remember and go through it.
Let go and just remember all of that?
And let go and let it pass.
Okay. Just like the pain.
Yeah.
It's an illusion.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is.
So when she remembers her past, and just accepts it and lets it go,
mm-hmm.
it'll just, the illusion of it will just dissipate.
Correct.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Good. How can she explore that life? Should she just remember it?
Yes, she should.
Okay. Could you assist her with that so that she can get through this and move on to her spiritual path?
Yes.
Okay. Is there anything that you else have, that you've seen in her body that we need more addressing?
No.
She's good. Okay. Would you, before we finish here, seal her up in a beautiful bubble of white light so that she's totally protected?
Yes.
Wonderful. And would you check for me her aura to see if there's any leaks in the aura?
Upper side.
The upper side?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What's wrong with it?
Around the head.
Okay, would you seal that for her so that nothing comes in and comes out from there?
Yeah.
Okay. And let me know when you're done. You want her totally intact in that beautiful white bubble of light.
Mm.
And would you check for the health of all of her chakras and let me know how they're doing? Tending to?
Yes.
Which one?
Solar plexus.
Okay. So would you continue working with her on that?
Yes.
Thank you. And can you scan her body to see if she has any implants? Either in her physical body, or ethereal body, astral body, mental body, any bodies that you have, can you could look at, see if she has any implants.
No.
No, good. Okay. Now, you've been talking to Anya and through Anya for a long time, and she may go home thinking that she's answered her own questions. Has she been answering her own questions?
I am her.
Mm-hmm. Tell her exactly who you are.
I am your higher self. I am accessible to you every time. You get quiet. You can hear me. I have been with you and I love you. And you are never, ever alone. You are always with me.
Mm-hmm. And why have you brought Anya here today to this session? Because I'm sure it was your idea.
She needs to see and learn more about herself.
Mm-hmm. Has she learned what she came here to learn in this session today?
Yes, she has.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, she has.
Do you have any final message for Anya or for me today?
Love is the answer to all.
Love is the answer to all.
Mm-hmm. Love each other.
Love each other. Beautiful. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. Waking up now, eyes open. Nothing bad.
Huh. Oh, God.
How do you feel?
I feel great.
What do you remember?
Wow, it's so funny because as you were waking me up, uh-huh, I was thinking to myself, oh, I can remember everything,
mm-hmm,
but now I don't think I can. Like, I remember...
Everything's disappeared?
Mm.
Like a dream? It's kind of fading?
Kind of, yeah, kind of. I remember the few lives that I have described.
Uh-huh. How long do you think that you were in this journey?
20 minutes.
2 hours.
Oh, my God. Oh. Really?
2 hours.
That's unbelievable.
It was amazing. It was amazing. You did very well.
I didn't hear the person you said on the...
Good.
I didn't hear.
Your conscious mind was quiet.
It was quiet.
Good. Maybe she took the suggestion before we even started, huh?
Mm. I know. But, I could see how... sometimes I didn't see anything, but I felt it.
Yes. Well, everybody's different. Some people see, some people feel, some people hear. You know, it depends on the type of person that you are, how you pick up things.
Right. Oh, I cried. I remember. I cried.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot why, but I know I cried. Yeah, I don't know why I cried. But interesting. Yeah, it was great.
I could definitely see where you picked up some of these feelings that you had from a different life, not being able to speak. You were pretty much punished for speaking out. You weren't allowed to speak out.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And that has kind of followed you into this lifetime. And you don't need that anymore. You're a healer.
Oh, no.
You have healing hands.
Oh my gosh, that's right about this. Like,
your higher self said that so many times.
But it's just so funny because I'm like, I heard myself speak and I'm like, why am I saying this?
But like, it is over and over and over again. Like, you have to hear this. This is really important.
Mm-hmm.
And seeing yourself on a podium speaking with people.
Yeah, so I'm like, am I imagining it?
You did really well. So, what do you think? Do you recommend this experience to other people?
Oh, absolutely. Oh, and I definitely do.
Would you want to share this with others? Cutting out the personal parts? I think the past lives were very interesting.
I mean, I don't mind not sharing it because mm-hmm. you're not going to reveal my name, right? I mean,
not
going
your
to
last name anyway.
I'm like, oh, here we go.
People aren't going to be seeking you out.
No, I know. No one cares.
So is this something that you want to share? It's a beautiful experience.
Yeah. Yeah, I suppose I can, sure. I don't know if it helps people.
I don't know if they can hear you.
I know, because it's just so, you know, interesting. The part is, like I felt like so much warmth on my chest that it was so overpowering that I couldn't, like I couldn't speak up. But it's not like, it's just warm, like my whole body, like especially in my chest, it was so much warm.
What did it feel like? It was a healing type of sound?
Yes. Like overpowering.
Really?
Like, yeah.
Did you get any other sensations or feelings?
Just warm. Warm. The sensation on my head when you were, that was very powerful on my head. It's just like vibration. Like I literally felt someone was taking out. That was very powerful.
What about your solar plexus?
Just round. Just like
spinning?
Yeah. Energy. Yeah, it was amazing. It was amazing. Wow. But it was so funny when you were waking me up. I'm like, no, I want to stay here. I'm sure you hear this a lot, right? Because it's
well, it's if the person feels good, hey.
I mean, not everyone will be this way, right?
No, everybody has a totally different experience. Totally different. You had a really great connection.
Yeah.
I had a hard time hearing you, even though I had a headset on.
You did, see?
Yeah, I mean, when you turned away and the microphone wasn't facing me, it was hard to hear you. Because, you know, that's why I wear a headset, so I don't have to strain
to
hear you. And I do repeat things
so
that you can hear it on the recording. You know, and this time I tried not to speak so much because your higher self was just on a roll. But I do like to repeat things so that you can hear it, so you can figure out what you're saying.
Yeah. It was just harder to speak because I felt like throughout the whole time, just like this white, just energy on my chest. Like, like I was afraid if I was going to take a deep breath or speak louder.
It was like sitting on you?
Yeah. Yeah.
But it was a good feeling.
It was, no, absolutely. It was good feeling.
Like an angel on your chest.
Yeah. It was not, everything was really.
It was a beautiful.
Yeah.
Great. Let me say my goodbyes here.
Okay. There's some high-tech camera.
High-tech.
You certainly look it.
All right. So, my name is Alba Weinman. I practice hypnosis here in Miami, Florida, and we just had a really beautiful session. If you would like to book a session with me in Miami, you can visit my website, www.albaweinman.com. And thank you for watching, and until the next time.